The next thing we want to do, I didn't really talk about how to import this character, but basically how I imported it was I used add, and I went to a place where I had an asset, I used it, okay? So I just use append, so you have this, you can open that and go directly into your objects and select press A and append. So I appended this from a file vendor file. This character was made in Polyplate, so I just gave you this clone add. But you can actually remove it if you wanted to. So this is actually something different, so you can just hide it and you see his wonderful looking eyes. Okay, that's awesome. So we want to be able to put this guy here, so to do that, I'm just going to get that, and I like dropping him very close to the starting point. RZ, just RZ 9, RZ 18. We'll have this here, so this guy sitting down. Yeah, I like him touching the floor. Okay, so now I'm gonna go into my pose mode and I'll select every single IK chain. That's this one here. And that's this. And if you move, you see that it moves as well. So you have to move the main control button. Also, I will select that object and drag it up like that. So if you look at what is happening here, trying to sit him down on this table on this system here. So we just hope that it's not too big for our wonderful bicycle. So just bring him up. Okay, I think this is okay. So we're quickly going to pick this up. And try to match it with the pedal or the bicycle. So look at the pedal is a bit smaller than the back, so you have to tweak a little bit sometimes. But in the meantime, let's keep going. And this one should be there. So I'm going to quickly select that and sit him down. So the leg can actually come down. So I'm sitting down. Okay, so I'm going to select that. So select this, drag this to the front, put this here, another one here, so I have it. I can also find this. Okay. So he can be using that and okay, so the question is how do you move? Let me quickly to hold this first. So grab this with G, with it. Okay. on G to take it back. I said it was twisted, so I can just go. No, it won't stick in there. There's rotation to that. Okay. So on the right, so out, down. I think I'll be able to put in his hands so I can hold this there. Grab this and push it forward.
So this is the full server for your house. So to move this completely, go back to parents is but instead of parenting, I will use constraints to constrain this character so that he moves together with parents. So this one does this particular one. Comparing this entire to the way for the just a bit, so that I can be able to just move one person at every other person. So what I will let me test this here and see how it's going to be. So I'm going to go to constraints. And copy location. So we'll use this if it will not displace our card. So how works this? So let's test and see if it's going to be able to work for us. So I'm going to select this. Now move. So we will realize that it's going to be good for us. So I'm not sure I know what this is. I need to remain control. So I'm going to go to copy location and select the constraint for this one. Okay, change it to local specific one. Sometimes there are some of them that we know what we want to do. Let's try another shadow. I move this. And shadow should be able to work for this. Okay, I think shadow should be able to work. So I'll use the shadow constraints. Because the copy location will not work with it. So I use the shadow constraint to get the what's it called? That's the of a bicycle. So what I will focus on right now is being able to make this guy to move. So to make him move now, I will focus first on making this bicycle. So I'm gonna put in a part here. So for now, I'm going to use a verse. Easier flow. So we have this here. So we're just going to focus on a very simple thing. I would like it to be okay. So it's not just here. I'm going to do something interesting. So I'm going to select this one. And I'll try something here. Let's go for constraint and say clunky. So sometimes you do this and it's going to be good. So when it does that, so that will not be a problem. You just quickly select this and animate. This. So the whole idea is we want to be able to select this, and when we move, we should be able to move along this path. Now, to test whether it's really moving, let's bend this path. So I'm going to just bend it a bit. Okay, so I have it here. So I want to make it go just a bit like that. So I'd like to try this again. Let's select the main control for the bicycle. Make sure that we're actually going to okay. We can go to see. So kind of this, then fill this work along that path. So we use a quantity function to do this. So all I have to do right now is to first of all bring the curve up to this so that I can minimize my false having my report. So I'm gonna turn on my auto keyframing. So we're going to animation right now. Perform auto keyframing and I'm going to have to go to key and say I want to animate location and rotation. I prefer to do velocity because I'm going to be doing some other kind of animation very soon with my character one. So I'm going to focus first on animating this bicycle. So first I will select my bicycle wheel and I will tell it when you are here, please. So just move it. Because I'm not okay framing, it will be framed automatically. Whether I press I. So another way is you can just press I. Okay, and you see our 9 frames added here. We have added a lot of frames for the scaling, the rotation, and every single thing. So the other rule that we could actually follow when we're doing this, but I wouldn't want to bring to that. So I'll quickly go to 250 here. So for the 250, I'll just come in and I'll just try to do it. So now, basically, this might be too short or too long for animation, but we don't have to worry about that yet. So what I'll do, I'll test my animation. I'll look at the frame as which is playing. Okay. So I see 24 frames. Alright, let's see. It's not very smooth. To make it a bit smooth, because we want to really test how this is working right now, I'll just go to render properties and go to simplify. So I'll release the subdivision to enable the view possibility light. So we're working for. Okay, so we have this. I think I like the speed, it's not too fast and it's not too slow. So let us just finish this here. So I'm going to come up here and I will now focus on the new thing, rotating this on the Z axis. So from here now, you see that just from here it goes in. So, coming to here, and here is here. So, here we go. Rotate on Z axis. So, the 140. That. I'll go to 160. Now, basically, I'm going to get a reference I'm using to do this, but I want to deal with that reference first. If I get a reference, I couldn't enhance my reference yet. So, that's the standard thing, right thing you should. Get reference first, and that's how you make it look very easy. So I'm just going to go over there. The last frame, and sometimes what I should have done since. That was true fun. Let's just grab animation right now. This is what you see. So you could do other things like slant it and whatever. So finally you have this. We're gonna make this a cycle. So you want to cycle this and have it in a quick plane again. So first let's go to this one here. So I just thought of an idea, because the way this thing works, if you select this, let's test this here. I'm gonna rotate this. Okay, so I want to see here this one is parented. So I'm going to select, and I think I will go with select this and rotate this. Wow. Okay, all these ones are parented to it. So I'll rather take this one and parent it to that one. So it has a new parent now. Rotate and wire. Okay, yes. So we have this for this. So that's all we have to do. This one is parented to this. This is parented to that one, to this particular one. So I think for us to make it easy for us, we just use this. Okay, so I'll say when I'm here, I'm gonna make a cycle that will be about let me just say 20 frames. You can always in our any editor, you can be able to squash and like compress the time so that it's a bit faster, or you can make it slower depending on how it is. So I'm going to R, let me just press I. Let's see what's happening here. Set note, double click here and see what that is happening. So I here, press I over here. So it's not around that. So by the time it's here, look at here. I like it to be here. Okay. And don't worry about these ones, we're coming to that part very soon. I want to check something. I want to make sure that it's not touching. It seems to be touching the tiles here. Then we'll fix that later. So I'm gonna go over to here, this one, and rotate on the y axis, this one. So if you go back, you see this goes all backwards. So whatever is here now, this one is done. So complete the cycle, you have to go forward again. R, Y, go this way. Then I 40. Well, best thing I can do is just select the sheet D and just drop it here. So if you look at here, you see your cycle. So then you now do your real time, so you see if it's actually okay or not. Okay, so you see something happened here, that is not going to be used for us. So you see, it went back. So I just spotted that right now. So I'm going to do manually here, R, and 40, R, Y, and take it back to somewhere there. Okay. Make sure it's actually smooth. I look at here, I have here a 0, then here you also have a 0 formula, a 0 value, so you have 90 there, And here I should have preserved here. So I have so oh something happened here. Something. What was that? Okay. These lines now. This minus 90. And that is 0. Then somehow for animation or function. And then manually directly to correct it. So this is a good example so that in case you have issues with your animation, you can be able to look at what's happening here. You can trace that to here, so if you can see. Let's see what length it will be. Oh, it's meant to be 0. What is that number? Minus 270, and here should be minus 90. Let's see here. And so it shouldn't do that. So here is the problem. So why it went this way? So I'm going to quickly delete this key. And so I've deleted this key that's a bit problematic, so it will still be able to work. So bingo, once in the center. Basically, we can be able to see this one here, or this one. Let's see, this is my function. Oh, actually, this is my function. Let's run it back. So, the numbers. Hello. There's that. Then, by here. Let's delete this again. Okay. Then I'll put a parent in my what should we do to this? So, okay, I think I'm getting on point. Let's see. Minus 180. Minus 260. So from here, goes down. So let's check it again. So here, y is 0. Here, y is minus 180. Let's see. I'd like to reduce my keyframes. Okay, and this should work. Then, okay. I think it will be fast, so I'm going to select everything from this here, and our first test. scale of this animation to be about 70. Okay, so what I want to do right now is to go ahead and make this my character to follow it. So if you actually go into your animation, you see that when you select this, you see animation here. So let's change this to action editor, and this one is, we're going to name it bicycle. Probably let's use that and click there so that have a fake user. So even if we try to remove this, we can animate this to do something totally different. And still here we have a separate animation from the last. So I'm gonna go ahead to this one here. I'm gonna call this okay gear action like this. Again by default. So the next animation we're gonna have, let's get a fake user, is to use this one. So what I'm gonna do right now is to enter into placement. So I'm gonna be pulling the cycle, this feather here. So look what's happening here. So just quickly, I could animate all the keyframes here. So if I want to, because I might need to do some other things here. So what I'll do, I will come in here and create a new keyframe, call it character animation, and click on that in the meantime. So it's with everything, and press N, press I, and I. So that will remind you that it's going to be there. So quickly go to there. So my focus of my animation right now is here. Okay. So we'll go to the tenth one. And I think I would like to go to 20 yet. Remember we scaled the animation, so it's no more way we were before. I like animating to numbers. So I have this here. I like to start with the 10. So I click here. I think I prefer going for layout, which has a bigger screen. So slide that again, going to my pose now. Now it all comes any camera, so not bothered about that space. So I think I will follow just one way for the meantime. Go back. So the time is at 20. I want it to come down here. Let's take that away. So don't worry about if we're going to push that straight.
30. Now remember, obviously, we're going to continue the animation to suit whatever we're doing. So we have here. So this is more like the blocking stage of animation. So here, that's when it's done. We're going to go straight to this one here, and I'll try to align it to the right. So we have this, and then press I. So press. Let me turn this off and show you something. Location and rotation. Press I. Just change it back to location rotation because that's the first my animation. So first I and say when you are 20, I like you to give him certain things if it doesn't malfunction. Let me check the one that will if it's the what. So we want to do that. So and I here, we keep on going to this game. Let's see something. That's something over there. Like it to do this way. And first time we have this goes on. Then here I like it to go to that way. So it doesn't flip or rotate in. In the real world, it's gonna so there's a passing code so you have to info and then we can just quickly do that now. Press I over here, that's a allow people. Okay, so we have this here. Then use up. So comes up. Here to 40. I like to do ROI digits here. We have 50, this is right. There you can see the animation using. Okay,
areas. Just maintain my 50 different. Now, I want to correct this now by times 2x. So the fastest way I can actually correct this will be to select this and let's see if yeah. Then put all of them into the thing. So I like to. I'm going to go this way. See, can you touch it? If I find this one here, and here, right? It's very close to this. Can you touch it? Okay. And so what's happening on the other side? So if you click copy this location, go over here and paste the location. Go over to here, make sure that it's still there. Into here, paste the location. And here, also paste the location. Right now, I know I want to come over here, but I will focus on the next one. And this I will have to do the other parts to be a bit better. So, one is here. I want it, this character. I'm going to select the right again. This one is here. So, I'm going to press I. So, I know. Rotation. So when it goes back by 10, we want it to come and join the feather. Then go to train. Let's say I'm gonna get everything right here. I just do a basic button first. Go over to here. This is what's happening. Right here, let's test something. Let's make sure we are going to be able to finish. Come reserve and be a winner. And then it's kind of this. I'm going to go down here. And about 50. I'm going to keep it down to about this. So I have it. So this is the basic button for our animation. So if you look at what we have right now, we're going to have that. So you want to be able to fine-tune this a bit better. So select that, select the main control room, bring it down a bit like that. Also, right here. So right now I have a basic blocking. So I'm gonna make this video a bit simpler by stopping here. So in the next video we'll be able to learn how to make this to keep on working and like cycling continuously. So but we're going to do our final next video. After I find the animation that I can be able to make it to keep on moving. So thank you very much for listening. And I'll see you in the next video.